How long does it take to get the 1,000 subs and 4,000 watch hours you need to apply for monetization? For every 173 views, you will get around 1 sub and 3 watch hours. At that rate, it typically takes 3.5 years to achieve a 12-month period of 4,000 watch hours. About 1 in 10 channels have passed this threshold, but 1 in 4 channels have not made it to 10 subscribers. Newly monetized channels typically earn between just $2 and $27 a month from ad revenue. You can measure a channel's rate of growth if you know its total views and how many months it's been operating since its first upload. The growth is views divided by months squared. The typical growth rate for new channels is about 210. However, the typical growth rate of the channels that YouTube recommends on your homepage is 137 times higher than that. And this can make it seem like a faster rate of growth is much more common than it actually is. Most YouTubers you subscribe to were probably monetized in around 3 months, which is the amount of time it takes the typical YouTuber to reach 10 subscribers. So how do you grow a channel faster? Well, you have to get more views per video without doing any more work. The most important thing you can do is help the YouTube algorithm match your video to the correct audience. But passive improvements like using better equipment, microphones, lights, cameras, etc., make future videos better without more effort. And also simple efficiency improvements like batching video production let you make videos more frequently without sacrificing quality. Knowing a topic's interest over time is also helpful because if you simply wait to release a video until the topic ends up in a news headline, gets mentioned by someone famous, etc., then the video is going to get more views without you having to do anything else. Of course, if you wait too long, someone else might release a very similar video before you do, making your video irrelevant. But YouTube is a huge platform with an enormous diversity of viewers, so a video is never just generically good. It is good for a particular audience. There's a subset of people on YouTube that will love your latest video and a subset that will hate it. YouTube's algorithm tries to show your video to people that will like it, but it doesn't always succeed. And you can help it and you can hurt it depending on the data you provide. YouTube shows your video more often when it gets clicked on more and watched for longer by a specific type of viewer. So it's really important that the kind of person that clicks on the video also wants to watch a significant portion of it. Making sure that's the case is a matter of understanding who the audience for your video is and molding your script, thumbnail, title, and description to fit that. Having a clear vision of your audience is important for making sure that you've made both the video and all the metadata you provide for it point to the same kind of person. If the various data points don't match, then you're sending YouTube mixed signals and the algorithm will show the video to people that don't like it and it won't do well. To make this all concrete, I went ahead and found several dozen YouTube channels with less than 500 subscribers. So new channels, mostly uploading video game footage. I watched the most recent upload of each channel and looked for specific problems. And now I can tell you the top things I saw people doing wrong that are easy to fix. First, people's video descriptions suck. They're usually blank or contain a handful of links, maybe some generic channel info or meme text. This is completely wrong. The first line of the description will show up in search results and help convince people to click on the video. It can't just be a link to your Twitch. It needs to be a real description of what's in the video. YouTube will automatically transcribe what you say in the video to get an idea what it's about, but there's some higher level information that's not going to be in there that you need to specify explicitly in the title and the description so the algorithm understands the target audience for the video. So for video game footage, your description should address things like, what's your game objective? What character are you playing as? Are you exploring a particular location or quest? Are you going for an achievement? What system are you playing on? Are you playing for fun, with friends, competitively, with strangers, online, offline? Are you a new player? Are you a veteran? Are you playing with mods, experimenting with your character build? You need to put that stuff in the description because it matches different audiences. Some competitive players are mostly interested in high-level play with the character or mode that they specialize in. Some people suck at the game and just want funny highlights. Some people haven't been able to play with their friends for a while and want to vicariously experience casual play through your footage. Some people want to see people playing the game for the first time so they can relive that experience secondhand. You need to be targeting a more specific gaming audience than just people who play this game. That's not good enough. And this points to a larger problem, which is just people making videos that already exist. If all YouTube knows is that you uploaded footage for a game, they're not going to show it to anyone. There's already videos for every game that have proven track records of getting clicked on and watched. you need to be adding something specific and different. For gaming videos, at a minimum, you need to talk over the footage. I don't care if you have to dub it over after the fact. You cannot just upload raw gaming footage. You at least need to be adding your personality to it. Talk about what you're doing. Critique the game mechanics. Talk about other games. Talk about your day. Anything is better than nothing, which I saw shockingly frequently. And I understand if YouTube is just a means to an end. Maybe you really want people to follow you on Twitch. And if you want to link your Twitch or anything else in the description, that's fine. But nobody clicks on those links, just so you know. And you would know that if you used a link shortener like cut.ly, which logs the click for you to review on their dashboard so you can see which links people actually use, which is none of them. Put links at the bottom of your description for the convenience of anyone who is looking for them of their own free will. Do not lead your description with links. That is SEO poison, my friend. And while you're in the description, add chapters to your video. Long videos need to give viewers an opportunity to jump to a particular match, level, mode, area, quest, or whatever interests them the most. And you can then go to the video retention graph, see which timestamps people jump to the most, and know what viewers were looking for and would like more of. Chapters increase your video watch time, and they give you intel on your audience. Just make sure you do them right. Timestamps don't automatically convert to chapters. You need all your chapters together, one timestamp followed by one title on each line, and the first line has to begin with 00:00, followed by some chapter title. Speaking of long videos, though, everyone's videos are too long. People especially need to trim down the start and end of their videos. You don't even need separate software for that. You can do that in YouTube's desktop browser video editor after you've uploaded. The longer your video takes to get to the point, the more people will drop off at the beginning of the video, the lower your watch retention is, and the fewer time YouTube will show your video to people. But if you have real editing software, I challenge you, no matter what kind of video you're making, to apply the 80-20 rule. This rule, also called the Pareto principle, says that 80% of the importance of something typically lies in 20% of its volume. So after you think you have a video, find 4/5 of it to cut out of the final upload. For every 60 seconds in your video, there's 12 seconds that really matter and 48 seconds that are pretty much just fluff. And if you cut out the fluff and get to the good stuff, more people will keep watching. And now, my most controversial suggestion, do not ask people to like and subscribe. I do not recommend any call to action whatsoever. Don't ask out loud. Don't put one of those little animations in your video. Don't say it in your video description. Don't put cards or end screens with subscription links. Here's the thing. When you ask, people are much more likely to do those things. I'm not arguing that. What I am arguing is that consistently asking is going to hurt your channel more than it's going to help your channel. First of all, people have empirical evidence, for example, that if you ask people to subscribe, many times more people will subscribe as if you didn't ask. But what they don't have is empirical evidence that consistently doing that will grow your channel faster versus you consistently not doing that. And they don't have that evidence because it's practically impossible to calculate it in a way that's statistically meaningful. Point being, there's really no reason to think the call to action engagement metrics help much at all. YouTube doesn't really need likes, comments, or subscriptions to tell if somebody liked the video or not because they already have their watch time. If you clicked on the video and you watched it to the end, you probably liked it. And if you keep clicking on and watching videos from the same channel, YouTube will keep recommending you that channel's videos. Your return audience sees your new videos anyway. YouTube makes them effectively your subscribers, whether they show up officially in your subscriber list or not. At best, the algorithm will use the ratio or number of comments or whatever as a tiebreaker when deciding whether to recommend your video versus one that has the exact same click-through and watch retention. But I can tell you right now that your click-through and watch retention are garbage compared to the competition, and you need to spend a couple years working on those before you even need to think about thinking about whether or not maybe possibly the number of likes your video gets are going to help you squeeze out another 0.1% increase in your views. And the risk of asking people to like and subscribe is that some people will give you pity likes and pity subscriptions, and that's bad for your growth because then the algorithm thinks that it should recommend your videos to those people and other viewers like them. And if they don't really like your videos that much, they won't actually click on the videos when they get recommended, or they will, and they'll watch 5 seconds and leave, you know, maybe after leaving a like. And so pity likes and pity subscribers hurt your video click through and watch retention and can lead to you getting fewer views overall. But even if asking people to like, comment, subscribe did give you some tiny edge in the metrics, in my opinion, it's still completely not worth it because of the damage you're doing to your personal brand. When you use the same script as every other YouTuber, that's how new people are going to think of you, as a generic nobody YouTuber. No one wants that. No one needs that. Please don't be that.